Hi, I'm Arthur.
I'm Candace.
And I'm Vivian.
And welcome to What's New with Microsoft 365 in April.
And as you can tell, we're working from home and doing the episode remotely.
And with so many people also working from home now, we want to share some information to help your business transition to remote work.
Like a step-by-step process on how to roll out Microsoft Teams, as well as training resources to help you and your users leverage Teams to stay connected and productive, even from home.
We'll also cover Microsoft 365 Business Voice, a new plan for small and medium-sized businesses that lets you make phone calls to any form factor, and all from Teams.
So, let's get started.
If you need to roll out Teams to your business to support an increasing demand for remote work, we have some tips on how to get started.
So create your first Teams and channels. First things first, create the very first Teams and channels in Teams. A team is a group of people who want to get something big done, like marketing or finance.
While a team is made up of channels where you and your users have conversations on things like a specific topic or a project.
And when you're just getting started, you can create two or three teams and channels for a special group of early adopters.
Onboard early adopters. Then you can send a welcome email to your early adopters with the teams you created and invite them to start and join conversations in Teams.
If you want to use a welcome email template, check out the description later for a few examples that you can customize for your own needs.
When you work on the email, make sure to include helpful tips like how and where to download the Microsoft desktop and mobile apps, or links to Teams training videos or help documentation.
Monitor usage and feedback. In the Teams Admin Center, there are usage reports available to give you insight on how your users use Teams. You can use these reports to view usage, user activity, and device usage across your business.
If it's your first set of Teams, consider reviewing usage reports twice a week, just to see if there's any emerging trends.
You can then take these insights and decide how to prioritize training and communication with your users based on your own productivity goals.
Get resources to plan your organization-wide rollout. And once you've successfully set up your first few teams and onboarded initial users, it's time to move forward on deploying Teams with the rest of your business.
To learn more on how to pick the right path to roll out Teams, check out the How to Roll Out Teams article in the description below.
This next feature isn't new in the Teams Admin Center, but we wanted to cover it since we know it's an important feature when you first set up a team.
If you want a deeper collaboration experience with external guests, like providing access to chat or sharing files with freelancers or clients you work with, you'll need to turn on guest access.
Since guest access is turned off by default, as the admin, you must turn it on before anyone can add guests to a team.
First, sign into the Teams Admin Center, select Org-wide Settings, Guest Access, and then toggle the switch on for Allow Guest Access in Microsoft Teams. It'll take 2 to 24 hours for this change to take effect.
While you're there, you can also toggle other features on or off for calling, meeting, and messaging needs, depending on what you want to allow for guest users.
And when you're done, select Save to make sure your changes get saved.
For more information on how to turn on guest access and which features you can toggle on for your business, check out the docs.com link in the description.
Once your company is up and running with Teams, there are additional resources on how to help your business transition to remote work.
Like this page on support.office.com, which covers that exact topic, as well as how to connect with employees and customers virtually, or how to manage and secure your business to run remotely.
And what if you want to share some tips and resources for your employees specifically? Then have them check out these bite-sized Teams training videos that are also available on support.office.com.
These training videos cover basics for your users, like how to start a chat and make calls, both internally and externally, to tips for managing online meetings.
And if you're looking for more scenario-based video walkthroughs, we've got you covered there too. Check out our small business training pages for how to get started working remotely and collaborating with employees and customers right away.
We've put links to all of these support pages in the descriptions below. So if you're using these resources to either roll out Teams or to get your company started with remote work, let us know your thoughts about these help pages and training videos in the comments.
For small and medium businesses ranging in size from 1 to 300 users, the new Microsoft 365 Business Voice plan is now available.
Business Voice adds a cloud-based phone system in Teams and creates an all-in-one communication solution that brings together calling, chat, meetings, and collaboration.
This means you can use Business Voice to make a phone call to any form factor and all from Teams.
It also simplifies the setup and management process. These functions are available in the same admin console as the rest of the Microsoft 365 services.
Additionally, the initial setup has been streamlined with a simplified Get Started wizard to help you set up new phone numbers in minutes.
Business Voice can be added to any Microsoft 365 subscription that includes Teams. To learn more and to try a free one-month trial, go to aka.ms/Microsoft 365 Business Voice.
And that's a wrap for today's show.
If you have questions or comments about the content we covered, let us know. We're open to ideas and we'd love to hear your thoughts.
And in the meantime, please like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. And of course, stay safe and healthy, and we'll see you next month.
Bye.